Welcome back to the 30th Pan-Pacific Conference from the Sandton Convention Center. I have here with me for the second time Professor Fred Luthens, who I also interviewed earlier on psychological capital. And this time around, he just finished his speech on the positive psychological capital impact on the change of South Africa's Robben Island, a very interesting subject.
Yes.
Welcome back again.
Thank you so much to have me back, and especially with this particular topic. And the reason why I'm so thrilled to be here is because I do feel that my concept of psychological capital, which I indicated is a scientifically based approach to basically understanding who one is and what they can become. And I found that in retrospect, and of course my psychological capital was not actually used in the 1960s and subsequently for the next 30 years, but in retrospect, I believe very strongly that the wonderful, in my opinion, wonderful transformation that occurred at Robben Island from when the political prisoners entered as, you know, I know Robben Island has always been a prison camp for many, many years, hundreds of years actually, we know that. But when the political prisoners came in 1963, and Mandela in particular, but also other leaders of the African black community came in, we were very, you know, interested in, well, what happened there? Because what happened was that they entered into an unbelievably tough, mild word tough, because it really was a hellhole that they entered. And we have social psychology research that indicates that when people are in power and you put them into a uniform, they often become very abusive.
Right.
And that's pretty much what happened when the warders, as they were what we call prisoners, and the guards, had this abusive approach to how they treated the political prisoners.
Right.
So what happened though was just unbelievable, because by the end, i.e., in 1990, when they the government, you know, voted to have representation of blacks and to do away with apartheid, That transformation occurred was one of the most important things in history, not only in this country, but the world. Mm. And I interpret that transformation of literally incarceration into a positive approach. The prisoners could have in their mindset to either make the choice that we're going to have revenge and hate, or unbelievably, they made the choice that we're going to take a positive approach. We're going to teach the guards, the warders, that they are also open for development,
right,
open for learning. And they didn't hate the guards. Mandela was very clear on that in his writings and in the quotes that we use from him. He didn't hate the guards. He hated the system, not the guards. And he took that whole approach then with all the political prisoners at Robben Island, that it became at the end, believe it or not, Robben Island University. And how did that happen?
Incredible.
And I think it happened because of their mindset. So in my psychological capital, it's based on the theory that, you know, about half of who we are is given, i.e. it comes from our parents, our genes, it comes from how we were raised as children, and then only 10% comes from our circumstances. And there's nothing tougher than the circumstances that these political prisoners found themselves in. But 40% is up to them, their own intentions of what they can choose to become, choose to believe. And they chose positivity over negativity.
Right.
And that choice of forgiveness, that choice of positivity, was unbelievably contributing then to, I feel, what has happened subsequently in South Africa and frankly, the rest of the world.
Right. What an inspirational story. Thank you very much for using an example from South Africa to kind of teach a lesson to the whole world.
And they taught us the lesson.
Right.
And all I'm doing is using my concepts, my constructs, my scientifically validated constructs. They had high psychological capital. And the psychological capital, as I hope you know from before, is made up of four positive psychology constructs. It starts with hope. The second one is the E, which is efficacy or confidence, is another word. The R is resiliency, and the O is optimism. Mm. That spells hero, And that's what those political prisoners were. They were heroes with high psych cap.
Fantastic.
So that's what I feel is so important, and I just feel thrilled to be part of, you know, being here and telling the story that they taught us. And through my construct, in retrospect, I think is a perfect example of what we mean by psychological capital.
Right. Professor Luthens, thank you very much for joining us again, and keep watching for more information on the 30th Pan-Pacific Conference.